Well, good morning. We are in Buenos Aires, Argentina. And I'm having a wonderful day. I'm out for a beautiful walk in this park. I'm gonna show you around the city of Buenos Aires today. We're gonna get a bite to eat. We're gonna wander around this beautiful park. And of course, we're gonna grab ourselves a great cup of coffee to get going. I'm having a really nice time here in Argentina. I will show you what my hotel looks like and how much it costs, and basically just give you a feel of the place. I also want to take this video to show you how I'm packing for South America. So I'm going to lay out all the stuff that I brought with me in my backpack. I'm going to put it all out so that you can see what I brought and explain why I'm bringing it. So we have kind of a combination today. One, I'm going to show you around Buenos Aires. And two, I'm going to give you an idea of how I'm packing for South America. Let's go. My hotel here in Buenos Aires is close to this awesome horse racetrack and the parks, the water, my morning walks. This is how they looked. It was incredible. It's a beautiful area of Buenos Aires. It's also packed in the morning with people exercising. The people here in Argentina are healthy. They're vibrant. They smile. They have a positive attitude. They have an upbeat lifestyle. I just felt a really strong energy here. And yes, of course, we had a couple of Argentinian mad dogs out in the park as well, having some fun. This was one of several very well-trained dogs that I saw while I was here, interestingly. And this park is massive that I'm in right now. So just enjoy the picturesque scenery. This area of Buenos Aires also has kind of the high-end condos down here by the park. And I found this fantastic coffee shop, and boy, did they just have everything fresh made that morning. And I was up pretty early too. I was out the door really early. They had everything ready to go. This was $4 for amazing cappuccino with cinnamon and chocolate and this croissant. Fantastic. The prices have been really good here in Buenos Aires, and I will keep showing you in these videos the prices of the food. To show you how light and casual I'm traveling, this is my outfit. I brought extra t-shirts, but that's it. One outfit. It's very casual, and I'll show you my belly band that I'm using as well. This is a lightweight, comfortable thing to wear so I can just sort of blend in through South America. So let's take a look at what I'm traveling with. Of course, you have the butt pad here that everyone loves to comment about. I'm telling you, this is a necessity when you're on long flights, 12-hour flights, 15-hour flights. Even if I'm on a 2-hour flight, I use this and it keeps my legs from being in pain. I have my backpack right here. Take a closer look at it. Okay, it's been with me all over the world. I also want to show you that right here in the side pocket, I've got a jacket that I can put in here. And it just comes out like this right there. And so I'm always ready if I need a jacket. It's very lightweight, but it's also very warm. And this will probably be my travel jacket from now on. And I got this for about $20 in the United States. Very inexpensive. Now let's move on to the other items that I have here. My universal charger, power brick, my iPod, and of course you've got your speaker that sets up a speaker when I travel overseas. Let's take a closer look at some of these items. A small sewing kit. I always travel with a paddle lock. If you're in any kind of a situation where you need to lock up your stuff into a container, which you will find in some hotels and hostels, okay? Drop phone. This is a fake, it's not a fake, but it's a broken phone. So I'm traveling with a drop phone. My Amazon Fire Stick, first aid kit right here, a selection of Band-Aids, and then all your antibiotics and all of your antifungals, okay? My laptop. A selection of clothing, very few items actually of clothing, toiletries, and some electronic cables that I use, okay? And of course, my travel bowl and my travel spoon. I'll show you how that works, just like that. And that's pretty much what I travel with. This year, I wanted to be as rechargeable as possible. I'm not carrying any batteries this year for anything. So I have my laptop and then my laptop charger. And on my laptop charger, I've got a USB port right there. The nice thing about that is when I plug in this charger that has multiple ends, I can charge everything that I'm traveling with. So I have my speaker that I take with me, kind of my sound system for the room. My flashlight is now rechargeable. This is a personal groomer. It's rechargeable. My earphones, and I have a power brick that I take with me when I'm filming. Everything can be recharged, and no matter what the voltage might be, it plugs in and it gives me good clean voltage out for my laptop right here. Okay, for my laptop. And this actually has two USB ports on the side as well. This is a perfect travel combination. Okay, this is a travel combination that is working really well for me. Let's take a look at the Clayton. The Clayton has a simple room here. This is kind of a traveler's hotel. It's actually very nice. For $50, this is more than when I'm going through Southeast Asia, but it's not a bad price considering that I am right in the heart of one of the best areas in Buenos Aires. I'm surrounded by parks all around me, and it's very safe. The common areas here at the Clayton are beautiful. Just take a look at the different areas that you can hang out. It has strong Wi-Fi. It also has a light breakfast that they serve every morning. They have coffee available every day. And actually all day long, you can make yourself a coffee. A nice traveler style hotel and located in the best part of Buenos Aires. Cafe Martinez has a long history in Buenos Aires. And this location has been absolutely wonderful. It's very close to my hotel. And I get the avocado and salmon bagel. Ooh, no surprise there.
That's great. Thank you.
It is a beautiful day. My hotel is located right here in an area that has a variety of parks. There's several parks that are kind of combined in one area here. And then it's also not that far from the water as well. The huge Rio that is, oh my goodness. I mean, it's so huge that it seems like it's a lake. But I really enjoyed my time with you today, showing you around a little bit of Buenos Aires, grabbing a bite to eat with you, a cup of coffee, and of course, showing you how I'm packing for South America. And we have a lot more to see. We have more of Argentina to see, and we also have more of South America to see. Come with, like and subscribe the video. Let me know in the comment section if you've ever been to Argentina. All right, I'll let you go. Aloha.